In this video, we're gonna be going over how to go from 0 to 1,000 followers on Instagram, or just gain 1,000 followers on Instagram every single week. Right now, there is a huge opportunity to grow on Instagram. In fact, it's the biggest opportunity right now on social media, besides TikTok, to grow a following, to really get discovered. And Instagram hasn't had this much discoverability or this much opportunity in like a decade since the app first came out. And there's an unlimited amount of content that you can make because there are so many different niches on Instagram. There are so many different people on Instagram. And finally, Instagram is letting us get more discoverability, and not only just our followers are gonna see our posts, but there's a huge discrepancy between if you should be posting on Reels, Stories, just your grid, and what kind of content you need to be putting out if you wanna gain 1,000 followers a week. Because one of the number one mistakes that I see people make is they're putting way too much emphasis on Instagram features that really don't matter. So I'm gonna address all of that in this video. So please, if you wanna gain 1,000 followers on Instagram every single week, make sure you watch this entire video, because if you miss just one part of this, it's gonna be the reason that it doesn't happen to you. And trust me, it's not every single day that platforms allow the reach and discoverability that IG Reels, Instagram in general, and TikTok have right now. So please make sure you guys take advantage of this. I do not want you guys to sit on the sidelines. I've been screaming about TikTok and all of these things for so long now, and so many people took advantage of it, but there are so many that say, hey Rob, I wish I would have taken advantage of this earlier when you first started talking about it. So please don't let that be you. Make sure you guys are taking advantage of this stuff. If you don't know who I am, my name is Robert Benjamin, and I'm the CEO helping you grow on Instagram, IG Reels, and TikTok. Please make sure you smash that subscribe button, because you are never gonna wanna miss another one of my episodes or another piece of content that I have, because there's so much of it that has helped so many people grow totally free right here on YouTube. In addition to that, I'm gonna be answering every single comment I get on this video in the first 24 hours. So please, if you have any questions, leave a comment below. I cannot wait to hear from you guys. First and foremost, the most underrated thing that people are not taking advantage of right now is you guys need to be following every single person that likes and comments on your posts on Instagram. The reason being is that that is really gonna allow you to connect with people. At the end of the day, if you're watching this video, if you're trying to grow it all on social media, if you're willing to take 10 minutes out of your day to watch a video on YouTube about how to grow on Instagram, then you guys need to be implementing the simple things that I'm gonna tell you about. This is not about luck. This is not about shaking your ass and going viral. This is about putting in the work, laying a brick every single day so that you can continue to grow thousands of followers a week. Eventually, you'll get exponential growth and gain 10,000s, hundreds of thousands, but you need to always return to the core of touching and influencing people. And the way that you actually influence people is by doing the things I'm about to tell you in this video. So please, everybody that likes and comments on your stuff, you need to be following them. If you have less than 10,000 followers on Instagram, you need to be doing that. The reason being, that's gonna build a much stronger connection. What a lot of people do, they'll just respond back in the comments, which you should do. They'll respond back in the comments, or they go like some of their stuff, go follow them. That is the most generous thing that you could do on social media, is go follow somebody. And trust me, when you do that, somebody is going to look at you and be like, whoa, this person followed me after I engaged with their content. I'm gonna engage with all their content, and they're gonna wanna do that to every single piece of content that you have. And if you could build up 1,000 people that do that, then guess what? You're gonna get way more reach, because you're gonna get way more watch time, way more engagement, way more people are gonna be interested in your stuff. And then Instagram is gonna know who to push that out to in the future and who your super fans will be. And like I was going on a point with earlier, if you guys are watching this video right now, I'm gonna guess that you wanna make a living or you wanna grow a huge following on social media, you probably wanna do both. And the way that you actually do that is by having 1,000 true fans. I know so many people on social media that have millions of followers that literally make no money, and I know people with 50,000 followers that make $100,000 a year from social media. The difference is they have a real connection with their fans. You need to build that real connection, and the first way to do that is gonna be by following every single person that likes and comments on your stuff. Also, make sure you answer every single comment and every single DM that you get. Even if it takes you an hour a day, you need to make sure you're doing those things so you're really interacting with your fans. Yes, this requires some work, but trust me, it's the most underutilized thing right now, especially when so many people just want to shake their ass and get a ton of followers. The next underutilized way to grow on Instagram right now is by posting way more on Reels. 90% of your focus should be on Reels. Stop focusing so much on your stories and on your grid. You guys need to be focused on Reels. It has the most discoverability right now, and this is the way that I would look at it. Your stories should just be updates and new content you're putting out, and just random stuff that you interact with throughout your day. Your grid should be really stuff that you want your followers to see. Whatever you think your followers are gonna be interested in, or updates or things like that that you have, or just if you wanna have an aesthetically pleasing grid, I would do that on your grid. Your Reels, though, it's gotta be made for people that have no idea who you are. It's gotta incentivize engagement. It's gotta really hook them in. It's gotta be made more for the masses within your niche, because that is how you're gonna get the most discoverability. And the best way for you to do this is actually to model yourself after success. What does that mean? That means going into your niche's hashtags, looking at what the top creators are doing in there, and then recreate that. Also, I would take content from TikTok and post it on Instagram Reels. Not repost it, but recreate it, add new sounds from Reels. I spoke about this in my last video, but TikTok just reached a huge deal with Sony Music. Instagram wants to do the same exact thing. That is why 90% of featured posts that you see on Reels, and if you don't know what a featured post is, it literally automatically causes you to go viral, which I'm sure you want if you're watching this video. So please use the sounds from Instagram in your post. That is gonna increase the odds that you get featured because Instagram wants to push music as much as possible so they could sign those huge deals with these music companies also. So please make sure you're doing that. But again, before we get into how to really get discovered and how to increase those and gain those 1,000 followers every single week, you guys need to make sure that you're using Instagram in the right manner. Reels for discoverability, stories for updates, your grid, just for stuff that you want to live forever and for people to see if they're scrolling through your Instagram. Succeeding on IG Reels comes down to a few simple things. We're succeeding on Instagram right now in general. First, what time you post. Second, what hashtags you use. Third, what kind of content you create. Fourth, who you're modeling your content after. And fifth, and finally, whether or not you're incentivizing engagement. Right now, like I alluded to earlier, the best way to get followers on Instagram, and if you really wanna go viral, I'm talking gaining way more than 1,000 followers in a week, like 10,000, 100,000. You need to make sure that you're getting featured on IG Reels. If you wanna get featured, you need to be posting at the right time, using the right hashtag, using sounds, like I said earlier, and modeling your content off of what has already been successful. This means that it's most likely to happen when you're actually posting IG Reels native content. This doesn't mean a repost from TikTok. This means recreating your TikTok on IG Reels. If you have the TikTok watermark on there, then odds are it's not gonna get featured because Instagram's not gonna push out TikTok content for long. Right now they are. It's no big deal if you repost your TikToks over to IG Reels, which is what a lot of you guys are doing. And it's not hurting your growth, but it's not allowing you to grow as fast as you can if you were to just simply recreate the post. Because yes, reposts from TikTok can get featured, but odds are they're not gonna get featured. Because like I said, Instagram is not gonna wanna promote TikToks on their own platform when they're giving out this much discoverability right now. In addition to that, one of the number one mistakes that I see people make is coming to their hashtags. You guys should be using 8 to 10 hashtags. You need to make sure the hashtags have a Reels discoverability area. If you go under the hashtag and there's not a huge Reels post right there, then do not use that hashtag. And if you're looking at a hashtag that has tens of millions of posts made to it and you don't have millions of followers, I wouldn't use that either. You guys wanna make sure that you're using hashtags between 50,000 posts to a million posts. That's gonna give you the best opportunity in order to rank under recent videos for that hashtag or in the featured Reels position for that hashtag. And if you're able to rank for several hashtags, that can literally change your life overnight because so many people on Instagram are constantly searching for hashtags. And if they search for a hashtag or follow a hashtag, that content is gonna show up on their feed and you're gonna get even more views. Which brings me to another point. You guys need to be posting your Reels content to your feed and then removing it from the feed. Please make sure that when you add text on the screen in Reels, you wanna make sure that it's not gonna be way too high at the top or way too high at the bottom, because when it shows on the feed and when it's on somebody's feed, they will not be able to see that text and it actually looks quite annoying and they're just gonna skip over the video and then it's gonna decrease your watch time, gonna decrease the click-through rate, and not as many people are gonna see that post. In addition to that, please make sure you guys take into consideration what your thumbnail looks like on your Reels post. When you have a really good thumbnail, I've noticed through my mentorship clients and just through analyzing people on IG Reels, you actually get way more views. Not too many people go to your TikTok and look at the grid and actually go through and look at things, but on Instagram, we're already trained to do that, so you need to make sure that your IG Reels thumbnails are on point. When it comes to posting on IG Reels right now, the best times to post on IG Reels are at 11 a.m., 2 p.m., 6 p.m., and 8 p.m. That is when I would be posting on there. It does not matter where you are, that is what time I would post. I would post at that time for your location. Similar to TikTok, IG Reels is gonna push out content closer to people that are in your area before they push it out anywhere else. This is very different from your story and your grid. Those you're gonna wanna post when your followers are online, but again, with IG Reels, you're wanting to get as much discoverability as possible. It's really where your growth is gonna be coming from, so please make sure you're posting at those times because that's gonna be the ideal time for you to post and get a lot of velocity on your post. Now, let's chat about how many times you should be posting a day. I strongly suggest you're putting out 6 to 10 stories a day, one grid post a day, and I would put out 2 to 4 IG Reels pieces of content every single day. At a minimum, put out 2, at a maximum, put out 4. Right now, I would not increase that. I would not go above 4 pieces on IG Reels every day right now. And since you guys are gonna be trying to get featured or just grow in general, please, 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 I cannot emphasize this enough. You guys need to incentivize engagement in every single post. The last 3 seconds of your post, if it wasn't already included in the post as a piece of feedback, you need to get people to follow you. No, this is not intrusive. I asked you in the beginning to sub to my YouTube channel. I'm gonna ask you again at the end of this video to sub to my YouTube channel. You guys need to make sure that you're incentivizing people following you because that is gonna increase the amount of followers that you get, especially if it comes at the end of the video. Nobody's gonna be mad if you ask them to follow you after you already just made a great piece of content. In fact, they're gonna be happy to follow you. It's gonna remind them to follow you. I would even put an arrow towards it so they know that they can do that. Even better though, is if you can mix that into your post and make it some kind of way. And I have several videos about this if you wanna check them out, about incentivizing engagement. But you need to mix that into your post so it's a feedback loop. It's a way for them to give you answers. For example, I'm just gonna throw this out there. I really hope YouTube does not shadow ban this video for this, but if you were to say something like, I'm gonna vote for person A or person B, who are you gonna vote for? If you're gonna vote for person A, comment below. If you're gonna vote for person B, click that plus sign. That's a way for them to give you feedback and let them know an answer to a question that you provided, or trivia, or get them to go really at people in the comments. Because please, make sure you do that. What that's gonna allow you to do, especially if you get featured. If you don't get featured, you're just gonna get consistent followers from that. If you do get featured, you're going to go viral and get way more views than you could have ever imagined, and way more followers. Because if Instagram sees that somebody watches your whole video and boom, they click and follow you, it's gonna push your content out even more, because that is one of the best factors that you can show the Instagram algorithm. Please don't be that person commenting on the video below and saying, hey, I got featured, but I didn't gain any followers because I forgot to incentivize engagement. I've seen this happen so many times and see so many comments about this. And on the contrary, I see so many comments that say, hey Rob, I got featured and gained 10,000 followers overnight. Thanks for your tips. So please make sure you're the latter and not the former, because I do not want you guys to have a post get featured, because it is hard work and you put out really good content and work really hard on your content just to get no followers from it. The biggest difference that you need to make right now if you want to start gaining 1,000 followers a week, or you want to go from 0 to 1,000 followers a week, are these things. One, creating content that you already know is going to be successful by modeling it off of TikToks that have really worked, or IG Reels that have really worked. There's just certain content that works in a 15 to 30 second format and certain content that works in a 10 minute format. So please make sure you're modeling your content off of things that work in a 15 to 30 second content and have already proven to be successful for other creators. Second, posting at the right time, making native IG Reels content, and using the right hashtag strategies like I mentioned earlier in the video. And then finally, making sure every single post that you post incentivizes people to follow you, because again, if you miss out on that, you're missing out on a huge opportunity. If you're struggling with any of these things, I strongly suggest you get into my IG Reels mentorship program. I guarantee that I can help you grow on Instagram in 30 days. If you don't grow, you're gonna get your money back, no questions asked. If you're not interested in that, I strongly suggest you just check out these videos over here or these videos over here. If you're gonna get into the mentorship, just go to the link in my description. It explains all about it. Thank you so much for watching this, and I cannot wait to see all of you guys in the next video.